Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, Commerce with Mac. Today I'm going to give you a piece of advice how to follow your passion. I'm going to teach you this way of entire process in just 10 ways. So you need to be very patient when you're watching this video, and please do not forget to subscribe my channel to learn with me more motivational things and also more exam tips and how to nail your exams. All these step by steps I put in my YouTube channel, and most of the commerce related subjects are also uploaded. Please hit the bell button so whenever I upload a video, you'll be notified. Let's move on to the content now. When I speak about passion, there's a lot of things we can speak about passion. Passion is something which you need to find what your heart says. Follow the footsteps what your heart says is what we say passion. But there are instances where your parents say that you need to get a good job, you need to study a lot as much as possible, so where you can sit in a corporate and you can earn as much as possible. That's not the real truth. It's the sad, bitter truth, but actually that's not the real truth. The reason people think that when you study more that you will get everything what you want. But I'm going to speak in this video that you should not go for a corporate and sit and work for 9 to 5 every day and earn as much as income. I'm a person who doesn't work 9 to 5 work, but I have my daily routine. It's completely different. I'm a lecturer full-time, part-time. I'm a YouTuber, like you can see a lot of videos which I'm uploading. But then you need to understand that if you really wanted to follow your passion, do what your heart says. Let's start. What's the first thing you need to know if you really wanted to follow your passion? You can see this person, a camera person, is taking a lot of time on understanding what is the environment to take a picture. But then what you need to do, the first thing when it comes to the passion following success, do what gives you satisfaction, but turn the satisfaction into money. So when you follow your heart, when you do what you really love, you need to give you 100% for it. And when you give you 100%, you just focus on the satisfaction. And when I teach, I see that the student should be satisfied. The student should understand. So that satisfaction gives me a satisfaction that the more satisfaction I make, the more money I get, because more students get enrolled for me. And even through YouTube, a lot of students come to my classes. The reason, they get a lot of satisfaction from the lecturing what I do. So when you get satisfied with what you do, then of course you can be successful as you really want. The second thing you need to know when it comes to following your passion, that's finding your talent. How do I find my talent? You might be good in sports. Sometimes, years back, you might be good in cricket. You might be good in football. You might be good in speaking to people. You might be a good joker. You might be a good stand-up comedian. You might be a good actor. You must be a good singer. So there should be some sort of talent hidden beside you, which you do not know. So actually, you need to bring up those talents. Sometimes I see my brother as a good talent on drawing, but he doesn't give focus on that area. So I really worry about him, because he has an artistic drawing, but he doesn't. He thinks that if we focus on this artistic view, I will lose my job. So most of the people fear, if I do something, I will lose this. If I do this, I will lose that. Nothing comes without losing. So you need to find your talent. So you need to lose things to get good things in your life. Then the third thing you need to know is follow your instinct. This is, when I say instinct, it's something you need to follow your heart says. It's something you need to believe that this is going to be true. This is going to be exact truth, what I'm trying to say. And something will say from your heart, you should quit your job, start working as what you really want. You need to be a piano artist, you need to be an actor, you need to be a singer. The heart will say sometimes, and follow your heart, follow your instinct. It will not say always, but when it says, trust me, that is taking you towards your footstep towards the right way. When I quit my job in 2019 in a certain big specific school, I was really worried, my parents were worried. And what am I going to do for living? I didn't worry about my future. I was so concerned about my passion. Everyone doesn't get a chance to do what they really want. I got a chance, so I'm giving my piece of advice for you. If you really follow your instinct, you can achieve a lot of things. I don't want to say what I am achieving now. In future videos, I will be showing you what I have achieved in my life. But you need to follow your instinct. The more you follow your instinct, you can become really, really, really successful. Then the next fourth thing I want to speak is all about speaking about focus on the quality, not the quantity. So what is this focus on the quality, not the quantity? You need to understand one particular thing. Quality is something which you always need to concern when you give a service. It's not the quantity. It's not about number of people you are delivering your service. It's about how, even if you deliver a service for one particular person, that service, the way you are going to give your work should be so much good. You're a good artist. You should draw it in a, you need to give your entire talent on that particular drawing. Then only people will appreciate you. So you shouldn't just work for appreciation rather than worrying about, you know, how much of money you can make. Money is not going to take you to the right step you want to achieve in your passion. So don't focus about money. Focus on your passion. You know, when you read the books of Robin Sharma, you when you read the book of The Monk Who Sold His Ferrari, the book called The Monk Who Sold His Ferrari, this book is actually giving a complete understanding about what is really a passion, what you need to do to understand the entire world. How do you can satisfy people? If you really love what you do, that's more than enough to make your life satisfied. Money can make you happy. Of course, it will do. But then passion can make your soul happy. That's what I wanted to say. So then next thing is ignore the negativity around you. Whenever you start something, you will always have these people coming behind your back and they will chatter, chitter, chatter, chitter, chatter, chitter. This is something. Whenever you start something, they will always have this. Like when I started my teaching career, my lecturers, like certain lecturers of mine, they said that you are not a capable person to speak. Now today I'm speaking in front of you, giving a sort of piece of advice because I, you know, I made myself a bit okay with the market. I ensured that I can speak to a large audience. So I made this fear by starting up small steps of initiative. So I ignored all these negative people around me. When I started my chartered accounting at the age of 21, I was having like so much nervous how I'm going to complete it. But then it will take some time when you ignore the negative people. Trust me, these people will, even if you pass chartered accounting, they would say like, you could have done a better qualification. I was in abroad. I worked in abroad. I came back to my country to do something better. And then the people will come and say like, why do you wanted to go abroad? Why you didn't go back again to abroad? Why did you come back from the country to your country? So these people will always find out some sort of ways to put yourself down. And these people will never, even if you become very successful in life, these people will come always and knick-knack and say something about your personal appearance, your personal way of speaking. Everything they will complain and always they will not be satisfied because they are so jealous of your achievement. So don't worry, you know, ignore the negative people. So ignore them completely. When you do something, they will always say that it's wrong. Like I have seen many students do advanced level and I ask them, why do you do A level without going for a degree, without going for a high qualification? They say that my mom used to say, my dad used to say, my uncle is so concerned that I should do the exams. So I did it. So it's not like that. You need to ignore the negativity. You need to take responsibility about your life, about your career. So that responsibility doesn't come in one day. You need to work hard for it. So when you ignore the negativity, trust me, you can achieve what you really wanted. Then the sixth thing, some people say that there's an easy way to achieve things. That's what we say, smart work. Some people even take the Bill Gates saying that people who are doing smart work will be hired rather than a person who is hardworking. It's something, it's better when you hear it. It's very beautiful. But actually, the root cause, the right way to achieve the things what you really want is the hard work. Without putting a lot of effort, without putting yourself onto that process, you can't achieve your passion. If you are really good in cricket, you should practice. You should practice every day, 5 hours, 6 hours. If you really want to be a chartered accountant, you need to study at least 6 hours to 5 hours for every paper. So the way you manage your time and the pulling yourself out of it and working hard is a part of hard work. So hard work is very important for every one of a person who is really going to find the passion. Build yourself. Like when you do mistakes, you are really making yourself a progress. Every time you do a mistake, of course, no problem. You started it, you'll learn some way and you somehow manage to come to this point of level. No worries. You will always achieve the success, but it will take a set of time. So slow growth is better than no growth, as I always say. Then we move on to the seventh part. We said as commitment and persistence. So this is what I always see from these people, whoever following their passion, they say that they have the commitment, but they don't have this persistence. Like they say that I want to do this. You know, I'm a good singer. They used to say 10 years back, I got this much of awards and I was so much praise in front of people. Then why you didn't follow your passion? When I asked them, they used to say that if I have followed your passion, I would have got this job. So people have some sort of a way of, you know, saying that, compensating a job with the passion. A job and a passion is not the same. Now, I earn a lot than a job. The reason I doesn't follow the job, I follow my passion. I love what I really do. So when you do, and when you do what you love, things will always happen in the right way. But commitment and persistence should be there. Like, I have a target every week, at least 2 YouTube videos I need to upload. That is persistence. Commitment, every week I need to sit in this chair and speak in front of this camera to make myself comfortable, and then put all my works to a side and focus on this particular thing. That is how a YouTube channel also can be made. So like that, I say that commitment and persistence doesn't come in one particular day. It takes a lot of time, but you need to pull off. Every time you work hard on it, you will try to improve yourself much better way. Then the next thing you need to achieve your passion is to take small steps. Like, if you really wanted to be a singer, if you really wanted to be a artist, if you really wanted to be a, you know, a chess player, if you really want to be a YouTuber, you need to take small steps. How do we take small steps? Like, every day, one step future. Now, for example, when I studied for my chartered exams, I'm not a person who can learn everything very faster. So I learned it like one by one, one paper. Every 3 months, I sat one paper, because for me, 2-3 papers at once is so heavy. And paying money for those exams was not affordable, because I'm from a middle, poor background to a middle family background. So getting this type of things to take towards a small, taking the steps towards the right way, it took a lot of time. So I say for the people who are thinking to take steps, take small steps. You don't want to take the entire thing. If you want to be a chartered accountant, if you want to be a YouTuber, you want to be a singer, you want to be a lecturer, you want to be successful on any aspect of passion you want. You want to be a good driving person, or you need to be a good driver, you need to be a good sportsman. Anything you need to do is take small steps. You can't do every day, but at least a day, a minimum particular time you allocate for your job, for your passion. Trust me, you will always achieve the things what you really wanted to. And then these people who always say that, if I follow my passion, I don't have money to eat. If I follow my passion, I don't have a family. I have family to feed. Now, some people say they need to follow their passion at the age of 30s. Some people say that at the age of 40s. You might take Colonel Sanders, the person who founded KFC. He started doing his research on late 60s. So people did their passion at late 60s. The person who found McDonald's, he didn't give up. At age of 55, the person was working. So you might see these people, you can really be successful. It doesn't matter with the age. It matters with the commitment, persistence, and the way you're going to do. But all these people had one particular thing. We say, do a full-time job, get some money, and from the money you are making, don't take all the money and spend it. Just allocate for your passion. Maybe if you wanted to be a singer, buy a guitar, you know. Then you want to be a great singer, you want to represent yourself to the entire world, you buy a camera, a good one, but you need to work for it, right? You don't get the money that easily. So you need to work for it, then buy a camera, fix the camera in front of a stand, then speak to the stand, start playing it off, then go live. Then you will be called to concerts. Then you can, like, when you are earning more than the job, like 3 times or 4 times higher, then it's the time you need to quit the job and you need to take on your passion. So I say, for all of the people who thinks that if you follow the passion, you will lose out your full-time job, I'm saying that manage things in a better way. If you really want to achieve your passion, you need to work. You need to work at least, you know, if you are a person who is working in a corporate 9 hours, you need to work at least 16 hours or 15 hours until you achieve your passion, until you succeed what you really wanted to succeed. So as I said that, if you do a full-time job and if you find your passion, trust me, you will be always much successful. And the last thing, but not least, is believing in yourself. Whatever things happen, you might take Phil Knight, the person who found Nike. He believed himself. 27 years of hard work he put on to Nike, but he didn't be successful. The reason, he believed himself, but then 27 years, it took him to make himself comfortable to believe himself much better. At the age of 52, this person is producing the Nike brand to the entire world. Nike was not Nike. He was following a brand called Tiger. He was selling Tiger shoes to people around the among the American country. So you might see these people's inspiration stories are one particular thing. Jeff Bezos, the person who started Amazon, he believed himself. Jack Ma, the person who had Alibaba, had believed himself. So this believing in yourself is something important. When everyone neglected you, when everyone rejected you, when no one cared about what you spoke, believe in yourself. If you do all these 10 things, trust me, you can do what you really want and you can achieve your passion. These are the 10 ways to achieve your passion. If this video is useful, please comment on the comment section and also please subscribe my channel. So I'll be putting a lot of more videos for your future upliftment of your life. See you guys on another video. Commerce with Mac. Have a nice day. Bye.